guys in the back. Can you tell those guys to step up a little bit, please? Everybody behind you, just step up. Unfortunately, we don't have a microphone, so you're gonna have to deal with my raspy voice, and hopefully you can all hear me. Ya shabab, arbu shway. So thank you very much, everyone, New York City, for coming.
How are you?
We are here today to stand in solidarity with the Syrian people in their time of need, period. Syria as a nation has been decimated for 4.5 years of struggle. Half the population has been displaced. Poverty is rampant. There are 4 million refugees in the surrounding countries, and about 8 million people internally displaced. As you've all seen, we want to make sure that us as Americans, the nation founded on refugees and immigrants, does more to help those people in need. To date, only 1,500 Syrian refugees have been accepted into the United States for resettlement. But yet there are 11 million displaced Syrians. 11 million, 1,500 out of 11 million. Just recently, this past week, Obama has stated that he will allow up to 10,000 in a symbolic gesture to allow some people in. But yet the IRC, the International Rescue Committee, and other NGOs have stated that at the very least, we should be allowing up to 65,000. Now there is a disconnect, ladies and gentlemen. And we want to thank you all here today for coming out, because we need to make sure that Obama hears us loud and clear, that we're not here for symbolic allowances of resettlement figures. We want to make sure that as a nation, we're doing our part to support the Syrians in need. And for that matter, to support all people in need and have a more compassionate strategy and policy focused on immigrants, refugees, and understand that at the end of the day, nobody is illegal, and that refugees are welcome here in New York City and all around the country. Second, we have to understand that refugees just don't obviously just pop up out of nowhere. There is a root to this issue that we as Americans have to deal with, and we have to reset the conversation. The conversation on Syria has avoided any sort of discussion as to why people are leaving in the first place. And this has to change. Can you guys hear me in the back? Great. So we have to reset the conversation. First and foremost, 90%, if not more, of the people killed in Syria have been killed by the regime that's in place today. And we need to understand that what's happening in Syria hasn't happened out of a vacuum, but it's in response to an uprising that started 4 years ago to overthrow a family mafia that has ruled the country for 40 plus years. 40 plus years. Imagine if the Bush family led America for 40 plus years. What would we do as Americans? I see some smirks, but that's what's happened in Syria. And that's why today we have such destruction and chaos everywhere. So what would you do as Americans if all of a sudden the government went to war against its own people? Committed mass atrocities. In 2012, 2013, when the first 2 million refugees fled the country, the number one reason why people fled was to escape rape. Systematic rape used by the government to ensure that the masses would flee and run away. This is the number one reason. Since then, 2013, we've had millions of more flee because of indiscriminate attacks from the sky. And the only people in the sky right now that are bombing the Syrian people is the Assad regime. So we need to understand that refugees don't pop out of nowhere. They are fleeing for a reason. As a Somalian poet said once, nobody puts their children on a boat if the land is safe. And so for that matter, we have to do a lot more as people, as New Yorkers, as people of conscience, to support those Syrians in need, whether they make it all the way here or whether they're suffering in camps across the seas, it's our responsibility to help people in need. Does that make sense, everyone? Thank you. organized by a group of individuals, Syrian Americans and allies who came together. I'm sorry, I can't speak louder, but please, everyone, come a little bit closer. I do have the raspiest voice, and unfortunately, I can't project well. But this rally was organized by Syrian Americans and allies to make sure that, one, that we're saying to Obama and pushing Obama to let them in, to let more refugees in. And then, two, to reset the conversation around why is this catastrophe happening in the first place. And then, three, as individuals, do everything we can do together to support those in need. And so what we're asking for each of you is to do three things today. One, you've already done it. You've come to the rally individual, so thank you. Give yourselves a hand. Two, tens of thousands of Americans have signed petitions, the White House petition, for example, change.org petition, and many others out there to let Obama know that this is unacceptable. 10,000 people, any symbolic mention is just unacceptable. So please, there'll be people in the crowd in a little bit sharing this petition around. Please sign it and make sure that your voice is shared with the tens of thousands who have done that. And then third, we want to make sure that whatever you have, whether it's a dollar, whether it's not, that you can support refugees in need and people in need. So open up your pocketbook. Whether it's $1 or $1,000, it will change the life of people in need. We're not going to be collecting any money today, but there are many great NGOs, like the Kenan Foundation, like the PCRF, Islamic Relief. Just want to make sure everyone understands that, you know, your solidarity is important, but also we need support, because nations at this point in time are failing. And us as people need to make sure that we step up to fill that gap to help our fellow brothers and sisters. So what we want to do is actually right now, like I said, this is going to be a little bit fluid, so bear with us a little bit. We're going to have a long moment of silence for all those who have died, all our martyrs, all those who have died and struggling crossing the seas. And so everyone, regardless of your faith, just take a moment of silence and say a prayer for everybody. Where are my chanters? There's a chance, but our main chanter isn't here yet. He's stuck in Jersey traffic, of course. This is a serious solidarity rally. But we're gonna do something with a little bit of rhythm, and so especially if we can right now, we're gonna start with some fun stuff, so just bear with me. Where are my fellow chanters? Da'aluya Shabab. So we're gonna do a little bit of like, Obama, let them in. 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 Obama,
let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama,
keep it up, keep it up.
Let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama,
let them in. Obama, let them in. Obama, let them in.